Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the types of polymers, their polymerization techniques, manufacture properties and uses of some commonly. The term polymer is commonly used in the plastic and composite industry. They are found in common household goods, in clothing and toys, in construction materials and as insulation materials. The definition of polymer is the monomer molecules combined with each other by covalent bonds and forming a long chain molecule which is known as polymer. And the technique to form the polymer is called as polymerization. Now we will see the classification of polymers. The polymers are classified in four classes. First is natural and synthetic polymer. Second one is organic and inorganic polymer. Third one is thermoplastic and thermosetting polymer. And fourth one is plastic, elastomer, fiber and liquid resins. Now we will see the number one, natural and synthetic polymer. The natural polymers are those polymers which are isolated from the nature. The example of natural polymers are cotton, silk, cellulose, protein, etc. And the synthetic polymers are the polymers which are synthesized from low molecular weight compounds. The example of synthetic polymers are nylon, dacron, terylene, etc. Now second classification is organic and inorganic polymers. Organic polymers are those polymers which in that the carbon atom is in backbone, and the normally all the polymers are of organic polymers, and inorganic polymers do not contain carbon atom in their chain backbone. The example of inorganic polymers are glass and silicon rubber. Now third class is thermoplastic and thermosetting polymers. Some polymer soften on heating and stiffen on cooling are known as thermoplastic polymers. The example of thermoplastic polymers are polyvinyl chloride, nylon, etc. And thermosetting polymers are those polymers which become infusible and insoluble mass on heating. Teflon and bakelite are thermosetting polymers. Then fourth classification is plastic. A polymer is shaped into hard and tough-like materials by the application of heat and pressure are called the plastic materials. The examples are polyvinyl chloride, polystyrene. Elastomers are a polymer which are vulcanized into rubbery product exhibiting good strength and elongation are called elastomers. Natural rubber and synthetic rubber are elastomers. Fibers are the polymers which have long filament-like material whose length is at least 100 times its diameter and which are converted into fiber. Nylon and terylene are fibrous materials. Liquid resins are the polymers which are used as adhesive compounds in liquid form. The epoxy resins are the examples of liquid resins. Now we will see the techniques of polymerization. There are four techniques by which we can produce polymer. First one is bulk polymerization. This polymerization is carried out by adding a monomer soluble initiator to a pure monomer in liquid state. A chain transfer agent is used to control the molecular weight of the polymer. The mixture is constantly heated to polymerization temperature. Once the reaction starts, heating is stopped. As the reaction is exothermic, the viscosity increases during the reaction. The advantages of this polymerization are, this is a simple process and highly pure product can be obtained by this technique. No isolation is needed in this technique. The disadvantages are, the medium gets viscous. Therefore, chain becomes restricted and termination becomes difficult. The rate of polymerization increases and therefore, because of uncontrolled exothermic atmosphere, the reaction can lead to an explosion. The uses of bulk polymerization are to produce the polyvinyl chloride resins from vinyl chloride. Now, we'll see the second polymerization technique, which is solution polymerization. Some disadvantages of bulk polymerization, which are explosion, are eliminated in solution polymerization. The monomer and initiator dissolved in solvent, also chain transfer agent, is added to control the molecular weight. The mixture is kept at polymerization temperature and constantly agitated. Depending on the concentration of monomer, the viscosity of solution does not increase. Therefore, the polymer form can be isolated from the solution either by evaporation or by precipitation. But the disadvantages of these polymerization techniques are chain transfer to the solvent cannot be ruled out completely, so it's difficult to get very high molecular weight product. The polymer formed is insoluble in its monomer or solvent and the precipitates out as slurry, and it is difficult for easy isolation. This polymerization technique can be used to produce the polyacrylonitrile and polyisobutylene polymers. These are also used for the formation of block copolymers. Now, third technique is suspension polymerization. It is one of the most widely used polymerization techniques. The suspension polymerization system consists of a dispersing medium, monomer, stabilizing agents, and a monomer soluble initiator. The suspension polymerization has several advantages over other polymerization techniques. Since water is used as continuous phase, it acts as a very effective heat transfer medium, which is very economical and more environmental friendly. The purification and processing of polymer is much easier since the very little catalyst is used and the final product is 100% solid resin. Practically all common thermoplastic polymers can be made by this method. This includes all high volume resins such as polystyrene, polyvinyl acetate, vinyl chloride, etc. Now, fourth technique is emulsion polymerization. In general, an emulsion polymerization system consists of a dispersing medium, monomer, stabilizing agent, and initiator. Water is normally the continuous phase in which the various components are dispersed by the emulsifiers. The uses of these techniques are, it is most widely used in industrial technique. The polymers which are prepared by these techniques are vinyl chloride, butadiene, vinyl acetate, etc. Very high molecular weight products can be achieved by this technique. Now we will see some industrial important polymers, their manufacturing properties and the uses of the polymers. The first polymer is polyethylene. The polyethylene can be prepared by polymerization of ethylene. And ethylene is prepared by two methods. The first method is the acetylene is hydrogenated to form ethylene and the dehydration of ethanol to form the ethylene. There are two types of polyethylenes, low density polyethylene and high density polyethylene. Low density polyethylene is produced by high pressure polymerization of ethylene using oxygen as an initiator. The properties of low density polyethylenes are melting point. It has melting point 110 to 125 degrees centigrade. It is 40% crystalline polymer. It dissolves in most of the organic solvents like CCl4, toluene, xylene, diethylene, etc. The uses of low density polyethylenes are, they are used for packing, wrapping frozen food, textile products, pipes, irrigation, etc. The second polyethylene is high density polyethylene, which is produced by two methods. The first method is by using the Ziegler-Natta catalyst, and the second process is used by metal oxides. The properties of high density polyethylenes is it has melting point of 144 to 150 degrees centigrade. It is 90% crystalline material. It has density 0.956 gram per ml. The uses of high density polyethylenes are: it is used for the manufacturing of toys and other household articles. The second polymer is polypropylene. The monomer propylene is obtained as a byproduct from the gasoline refinery. Polypropylene is produced by the polymerization of propylene by in presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst. The properties of polypropylenes are: it is prepared in isotactic, syndiotactic or atactic forms. It has melting point up to 208 degree centigrade. It is highly crystalline material and insoluble at room temperature. It dissolves in aromatic and chlorinated hydrocarbon. It resistant to acids, alkalis and oils. The uses of polypropylene are: it is used in appliances such as refrigerator, TV, radio. It is used for the preparation of pipes, storage tanks, seat covers, ropes, etc. Now, next polymer is polyesters. It has the functional group of C double bond O, ester groups. It is prepared by polycondensation between dicarboxylic acid and diol. Here, the groups R and R dash are if they are aliphatic, then it has melting point of 50 to 60 degree centigrade. And if we introducing some aromatic rings into these polyesters, the melting point is high. It is around 265 degree centigrade. It's commercially most popular polymer marketed under the trade name of terylene or terene. It is prepared by the reaction between dimethyl terephthalate and ethylene glycol to form the terylene. The properties of terylene are: it has melting point of 265 degree centigrade. It has good mechanical strength up to 175 degree centigrade. It is unaffected by many chemicals and it is resistant to heat and moisture. Many film magnetic recording tapes, aluminized sheets are prepared by these polymers. Polyvinyl chloride. The monomer vinyl chloride is obtained by two methods: by cracking ethylene dichloride in vapor phase, and second method is by reacting acetylene with HCl in presence of catalyst. Industrially, polyvinyl chloride is obtained by suspension or emulsion polymerization technique. Limited quantity of polyvinyl chloride is made by bulk polymerization techniques. The properties of polyvinyl chloride is partially syndiotactic and don't have regular structure, therefore it has low crystallinity. It is insoluble in vinyl chloride, alcohol, water and hydrocarbons. It dissolves in acetone. Alkali and acids have no effects on PVC. It is used in formation of cable insulation, equipment parts, pipes, lamination and fibers. It is cheapest and most widely used polymers. Main use of chlorinated PVC is in the manufacturing of coating adhesives and fiber. Now, next polymer is elastomers. Polymers which can be capable of being stretched rapidly up to 150% of their original length without breaking and also return to their original shape are known as elastomers. We will see some examples of elastomers. In that, number one is Buna S rubber, which is prepared by the reaction between styrene and butadiene. The monomer butadiene is prepared from butene, which is in presence of nickel and tungsten up to 600 to 700 degree centigrade. Second monomer is styrene, which is prepared by the reaction between benzene and ethylene. The polymerization of styrene and butadiene is known as styrene-butadiene rubber. It is strong rubber and it is used to make tires of vehicles. It has good resistance to air, heat and chemicals. Second elastomer is Buna N rubber, which is known as acrylonitrile. The second elastomer is Bunayan rubber, which is prepared by the copolymerization of acrylonitrile and butadiene. The monomer acrylonitrile is prepared by the reaction between acetylene and hydrogen cyanide. The uses of this elastomer are: it is extra resistance to oils, it has good resistance to plastic, flow cold, heat, petroleum, etc. It is used to make automobile parts, fuel cell, sheets, etc. The third elastomer is neoprene, which is also known as polychloroprene. The monomer chloroprene is prepared by acetylene. The neoprene is produced from chloroprene by the addition of HCl and CuCl and then after demineralization. The neoprene is closely related to natural rubber chemically. It is resistant to oxidizing agents such as oxygen and ozone. It is soluble in polar solvents and not attacked by alkali below 50% strength. It is used in oil resistant insulation, wire coating, shoe soles, solid tires, gloves, etc. Thank you everyone. The second elastomer is Bunayan rubber, which is prepared by the copolymerization of acrylonitrile and butadiene. The monomer acrylonitrile is prepared by the reaction between acetylene and hydrogen cyanide. The uses of this elastomer are: it is extra resistance to oils, it has good resistance to plastic, flow cold, heat, petroleum, etc. It is used to make automobile parts, fuel cell, sheets, etc. The third elastomer is neoprene, which is also known as polychloroprene. The monomer chloroprene is prepared by acetylene. The neoprene is produced from chloroprene by the addition of HCl and CuCl and then after demineralization. The neoprene is closely related to natural rubber chemically. It is resistant to oxidizing agents such as oxygen and ozone. It is soluble in polar solvents and not attacked by alkali below 50% strength. It is used in oil resistant insulation, wire coating, shoe soles, solid tires, gloves, etc. Thank you everyone.